the battery and they will give us a charge. So we provide them a heat and they give us the electricity. And this type of battery is known as thermal battery. The thermal battery may be used in future, but nowadays it is not mostly used. So what is thermal battery? Thermal battery technology implies the inorganic salt electrolytes. The working principle and the application of different type of thermal batteries having different working principles. The thermal battery are generally two types, and all these two types having different working principles. So what all are these two type of thermal battery? The types of thermal battery, the first one is the thermocouple converter, and the second one is the alkali metal thermal electric converter. So this is the two types of thermal battery we have. And now I will explain what is thermocouple converter. Thermocouple converters batteries work on the principle of Seebeck effect. What is Seebeck effect? Seebeck effect says that when two different electrical conductors or semiconductors in a closed circuit are kept at different temperature, then a potential difference or EMF generates between them. So let us consider this is metal which is made with the help of two different conductors or two different semiconductors. So what will happen? We provide at one side of this different metals heat source, and other one is cold one. So what will happen due to this temperature variation, the EMF or the potential difference produced inside. You can say the free electrons will come out, and that free electrons start moving, and that free electrons will cause a potential difference or EMF inside this. So we will connect it to wire at both ends. So due to this, the electrons start moving from this side to throw to the load to the this side. So due to this, the current starts flowing inside the load, and that load may be a light or small motor, maybe anything. The load may be anything, and this will get a current, and due to this that light will glow or the motor will run. So this is one type of thermocouple battery, and this battery is known as thermal battery because it works on heat. The second one is alkali metal thermal electric converter. So MTEC batteries, this batteries work on the principle of electrochemical heat engine. What is this electrochemical heat engine? What will happen when this battery we need to kept on a high temperature? So due to this, what will happen? The alkali metal, that alkali metal may be a sodium or maybe a potassium. So in this figure we have a sodium. That sodium vapor acting as a fluid. So what will happen? That sodium vapor start flowing through the pores of these conductors or pores of these metals. So it is generally having a three main component. One is evaporator, second one is vase, and third one is the condenser. So what will happen when we apply the heat source? The sodium vapor will get energy, and due to this vapor will become a highly pressurized. Now you can see this vapor pressure increase up to 50 kilopascal. So now the vapor start moving from evaporator to the vase to the condenser. When it goes to the condenser, when it reaches to the condenser, so what will happen? Due to the low temperature, its pressure reduce near to the 100 pascal. So in that way our sodium is circulating. So what will happen when this sodium will circulate? When this sodium will circulate, so this solid electrolyte separate the electron from the ion. So the sodium now the electron is separated from the sodium, so sodium will get the positive ions and one electron is separated from it. So what we will do, we will provide a two wire and with external load, so electrons start moving from here to the external load to again to the sodium. So now you can see here the sodium come here and it is ionized. When it is ionized, this electron is separated and this electron goes and it will reach the external load, and this sodium, it passes through the base, and when it reach the other side of the base, the electron is coming from the external load, it will again combine with sodium and it will become a sodium, again stable sodium, and it will reach the condenser. This is the working principle of alkali metal thermoelectric converter, and we all know this work on the principle of heat, and that's why it is also known as the thermo batteries. The thermo batteries nowadays not mostly used because it does not produce a high electrical current, and maybe in future this battery we can use. So this is all about the thermo battery. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel Angry Science. Thank you.